Fun Fact Friday!
You can't profess a Fun Fact Friday.
You can't profess Fun Fact Fridays. If you ready, time to have some fun. So many things to know, so many facts to learn. Hey, your kid professes Fun Fact Fridays. Your kid professes Fun Fact Fridays. If you ready, time to have some fun. So many things to know, so many facts to learn. Hey, every Friday, join your kid professors. Let's go.
Hi, I am Miles.
And I'm Ace.
And we are your kid professors.
Back from a long break.
Yeah.
Your kid professors, and they got the energy, teaching other kids all about Black history. So entertaining and so educational. Time to tune in. If you ready, here we go. Bringing you the facts right away. Talking about everyone from Rosa Parks to MLK. If you ready, let's go. Don't get no better. Two kids, and this is your kid professors. Let's go.
Sorry.
Yeah, we're working on a documentary. Check it out on Sankofa.com.
Yeah.
Well, and it's not out yet, but you can watch the first one.
Yeah.
And our stuff is on there too.
Yep.
And make sure you find out about our new game coming out.
Yep.
And scroll down below so you can hit the subscribe button. The like button, subscribe button, and sometimes notifications.
And it sometimes turns
blue. Today we're going to learn about Sugar Child Robinson.
Hooray! Who is Sugar Child?
Sugar Child
is... He is American jazz pianist.
Frank Sugar Child Robinson
is an American jazz pianist and singer. He became famous as a child prodigy in the mid-1940s.
A child prodigy is someone who's a master of one or more skills or arts at an early age.
This child genius played at many famous venues. He played for the president too.
And received top bills.
Frank Isaac Robinson.
No, Robinson.
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 Frank Isaac Robinson. You said Robinson.
No, I said Rob. Was born in Detroit in December 28, 1938.
And was the youngest of seven children. He was known as Sugar Child Robinson.
His mother gave him the nickname Sugar Child.
Ace, tell them how he learned to play the piano.
His parents didn't play any instruments, but they did have a piano that his aunt left at his house. But his lapis piano was his elbow and his fist.
According to legend, Sugar Chili, the youngest of seven children, he would climb up on the bench and teach himself how to play when he listened to the radio.
He won a talent contest for kids when he was 3 years old.
Imagine everybody's eyes popping out their heads when they're listening to him play.
I would like to play a song of my own arrangement, Sugar Child Boogie.
He used his elbows and his fists like this.
He went elbows, and then he also goes.
He did.
Yeah, elbows and fists. Stop. Let's tell you some fun facts about Sugar Child. 3 years old, he won a talent show at Detroit's Paradise Theater.
Wow. Yeah. He was only three, too. That's all. That's all. He's a pianist.
When I was drag, I couldn't even talk. Could I talk?
I could talk. I remember I could talk.
I could walk.
I could talk, but not walk. In 1945, he was discovered by pianist.
Pianist?
In 1945, he was discovered by Frankie Cowley, who also played piano.
MGM offered Frankie's father a 7-year contract, but he turned it down.
But later he signed a movie contract.
He appeared in the 1946 American movie, No Leaves, No Love.
He became a national sensation.
He went on a national tour and set box office records.
He played Catalani, this song, for President Harry S. Truman at the White House. He famously shouted out, "How I'm doing, Mr. President?"
What became his catchphrase, "How I'm doing, Mr. President? How am I doing it, Mr. President?
How am I doing it, Mr. President?"
President Truman gave him a big thumb out. Or two big. Or three big.
Five.
He became the first black person to perform at the White House Correspondents' Dinner.
He headlined for 1 week at the Chicago's Regional Theater, making more than $36,000.
That's a record that remains the biggest 1 week attraction of the theater's history. So no one's made more than that.
In 1950, he toured with Count Basie and appeared on TV. And in the short film, Sugar Chili Robinson, Billie Holiday, Count Basie in his sex it.
Okay, Professor, do me more. Tell me more and tell me more.
Okay, Valoria, here's more about Sugar Child Robinson.
Robinson had made a comeback as a musician in recent years. Thanks to American Music Research Foundation, in 2002, he performed at a special concert honoring Detroit music. Sugar Chili Robinson was the featured artist in the final Dr. Boogie show of 2013 on the 70th anniversary of his appearance at the 1946 dinner. He attended the White House Correspondents' Dinner on April 30th, 2016 with President Obama. He was applauded during the dinner and received a standing ovation as a picture of him as a child appeared on the video screens. And in 1952, he gave up music to go to school. And he said, "I wanted to go to school. I wanted some background in me. And I asked my dad if I could stop. And I went to a school because I honestly wanted my college diploma."
He went back to school and he finished high school when he was just 15. And he went on to get a degree in psychology. He went on and received 2 degrees,
one in history,
and a PhD in psychology. Can you imagine playing like that at 7 years old? And guess what? It's time for... What did
no.
you...
I want to say something.
What did you learn today?